I welcome all of you to the problem session. So, second PUC, atoms. In the previous classes, all of you learned what is atom. So, the size of the atom is very, very small. It is about 10 to the power of minus 10 meter. So, that dimension cannot be seen by naked eye and even with microscope or any instrument. So therefore, we thought of about models. Various models are proposed. So we have seen Thomson model, Rutherford model, Bohr model, and all those things. So we shall move to the problem session of this topic. The first problem is calculate the angular momentum of an electron in the ground state of hydrogen atom. See, what I have to calculate? Angular momentum. Where I have to calculate? In the ground state. Angular momentum of what? Electron. Okay? So you know that an atom consists of central positively charged nucleus and negatively charged electrons revolving round them. Therefore, the electrons are executing circular motion, so they have angular momentum, as you know, in first PUC. The angular momentum of the electron is given by, you know that, angular momentum of electron is given by nh by 2 pi, according to Bohr postulate. The second postulate, Bohr, according to Bohr quantum condition, it is also called. Okay? So, in the ground state means in the first permitted orbit, for the first permitted orbit, n is 1. Therefore, so the angular momentum in the ground state is h by 2 pi. If I substitute, h value is 6.6 into 10 to the power of minus 34. Divide by 2 into 3.14, this, if I simplify further, this comes out to be around 1.1 into 10 to the power of minus 34, okay? So, the unit of h and angular momentum is same, the h unit is joule second. This is how we can calculate the angular momentum of an electron in the ground state of hydrogen atom. Similarly, in the first excited state, so first excited means the next state, for that state n equals to, I have to multiply this by 2, okay? So this is the very simple problem which appeared in the examination for 2 marks. Next, we shall move to the next problem, that is, this problem has appeared so many times in the examination. Calculate the velocity of electron in the first 2 permitted orbits of hydrogen atom and then comment. First 2 permitted orbits means in this orbit n equals 1, in the next permitted orbit is n equals 2. We know that the velocity of electron in the nth orbit, we derived this formula, is given by Ze square by 2 epsilon naught nh. Okay? Let us substitute all those things. All the values are given. If you simplify, you will get the value of velocity, speed of the electron. For first orbit, n value is 1. For hydrogen atom, Z is 1. The charge on the electron is 1.6 into 10 to the power of minus 19 square. So the epsilon naught value, that is the permittivity, you know that, 8.854 into 10 to the power of minus 12, and Planck's constant is 6.625 into 10 to the power of minus 34. So if I square it, I will get 2.56 into 10 to the power of minus 38. If I simplify the denominator, I will get it as, use calculator, do the calculation in a similar manner. You won't make any mistakes. So try to follow the same method and same steps. It comes up to be 117.21 into 10 to the power of minus 46. If I divide this further, I will get it as 0.0218 into 10 to the power of 8. So if I shift 2 decimal place to right, I will get it as 2.18 into 10 to the power of 6 meter per second. Okay, this is the velocity of electron in the first orbit. In the second orbit, all the values are same, only the value of n will become 2. Therefore, V1 by 2, it is nothing but 1.09 into 10 to the power of 6 meter per second. Okay, comment. What comment can you make? Observe this value. So if you observe this value, will it be small or large? The speed of light is about 10 to the power of 8 meter per second. This value is almost 10 to the power of 6. The electrons are revolving around the nucleus with very high speed. The speed is not less. Therefore, you cannot catch hold of the electrons. It is very difficult to remove electrons from the ground state because the velocity is very high. Collision between electron and photons is probability is very less in the ground state because velocity is very, very high. That is the first comment you can make. Okay? So it is not so easy to remove the electrons from in atoms in their ground state. So the second comment that you can make here is, you see, observe V1 and V2. Okay, V1 is twice this, V2 is half of this. Therefore, electrons here are moving with very high speed. Electrons in the next orbit are moving with lesser velocity. In the next orbit, still less. Okay, so similarly to our planets, Mercury has high speed. Okay, so therefore, outer electrons go with lesser speed, inner electrons go with so high speed. That is the next observation you can make. That is what the comment, two observations you have to write for this problem. That is your comment about the value. Okay? Yes. So similarly, the next problem, very standard problem, calculate the radii of first Bohr orbit of hydrogen atom. Okay? So for the first Bohr orbit, the radius of the permitted orbits is given by epsilon naught n square h square divided by pi mz e square. Already we derived this formula in the previous session. Let us substitute all these values. For the first orbit, n value is 1. For hydrogen atom, z is 1. All these are standard values. You know all those things. Substitute them. Pi value is 3.14. M is the mass of the electron. Mass of the electron is 9.11 into 10 to the power of minus 31 kg. It is very, very less. Yes. So now substitute as usual, then simplify. If you multiply the numerator numerical values, then you will get 388.60 into 10 to the power of, this is square, minus 80. If you simplify the denominator, you will get 73.23 into 10 to the power of 6, minus 69. If you shift this minus 69 to the numerator, it becomes plus 69. Therefore, 80 minus 80 plus 69 is minus 11. If you divide these numerical values, you will get 5.31. Okay? If I remove one decimal place, I will get 0.53 into 10 to the power of minus 10 meter. 10 to the power of minus 10 meter is nothing but one angstrom. Okay, so that is what I wrote. So therefore, the radii of the first Bohr orbit is about half of the angstrom, 0.53 angstroms. Okay, so similarly, in the second Bohr orbit, all these values will be same. Only n value will be 2. That is r1 into 2 square. 2 square is nothing but 4. So if I multiply 0.53 into 4, I will get 2.12 angstrom. So here, what should be your observation? The radii of the orbits, so is about 10 to the power of minus 10 meter. So therefore, the size of the atom is of the order of angstrom. The size of the atom is very, very less, is less than nanometer. Okay, so these observations supports, so these are the merits of Bohr's theory. So in the next session, so we shall calculate the ground state energy of electron and the value of Rydberg constant. Then, so we shall move to even spectral lines also. So get ready for the next session. If you find some more problems from your notebook, so please solve some more regarding this. Thank you.